Here's the principle of Yahuwah. The Mashiach, the heavenly Messiah, was brought forth as written in Proverbs chapter 8. He was brought forth from the Father, and he is the light. He is the great and awesome light, and his light dawns on all the chosen ones. Yahuwah uses him, or he has the authority, because he is Yahuwah Elohim. And he dwells in heaven and in the earth. He dwells in the earth with the sons of men. Hallelujah. The principle is, when we sin, we are punished for our sins. We suffer and basically die if we don't repent. But he in his goodness, Yahuwah Elohim, descended upon a chosen one in the earth, a man. And this man suffered because the sins were on this man of the world. Actually, he suffered so we, the sinners, for all times who believe in him, would not suffer as much. Because as a sinner, we do have to be accountable for our sins. But Yah will not put horrible punishment upon us because of this man, the teacher of righteousness. He suffered greatly from a child. And he bore a lot of punishment all the way till it was all completed and done. The displeasure of Yahuwah was upon him. For all who would come after him, who believe in him, they would not be punished severely or as much. So he lightened our load, so to speak. The earthly teacher of righteousness, that Messiah, who suffered greatly, just like Eob, came as a man, anointed of Yah. He suffered to keep us from suffering greatly. Because we sin, we still have to go through a punishment. But while going through the punishment, we are humbling ourselves as well and seeking Yahuwah and understanding that Yahuwah is the only one that is who is our Savior. He used many folks, many people down the line, but he is the Savior. So we worship Yahuwah only. This is why the teacher of righteousness, he is the one that points the way. He points the way to Yahuwah, how we are to live, how we are to live to please the Father, how we are to stay away from sinning, how we are to be set apart unto him and have no other. He helps us to understand the word idolatry. Idolatry, worshiping or calling the name of any other than the Savior, Yahuwah himself. We understand that we follow the teacher and listen to him, but we only worship Yahuwah because Yahuwah is our Savior. He chose the teacher of righteousness, anointed him so he can endure, anointed him so he can take on our the pain that was due to us. He took a portion of it, the great portion of it. And with that said, he brought back the covenant so that we can understand the covenant that we will serve only Yahuwah and no one else. Once this is done, the teacher's work is finished in our life. We go on to believing in Yahuwah and serving only him and do kindness and righteousness and right ruling in the earth. The light of Yahuwah has dawned upon us and Yisrael, because Yah's chosen us, family of Messiah, to be intercessors for Israel. We have to keep his command. We have to call only upon his name. We have to believe and trust in him alone. Our life must show that we worship Yahuwah, and only him we shall serve. In this covenant, brought forth by the teacher of righteousness, he reinstated it, bring us back to the covenant he made with Abraham. And that covenant, Yahuwah blessed Abraham and his seed forever. If we believe in the Father, Almighty Yahuwah, Elohim, and we humble ourselves before him to only serve him, remove all pride and arrogance, then Yahuwah will send the prince next. The prince is going to be raised up. Because the priesthood, understand Yahuwah, that's complete. That we endure the displeasure of Yahuwah because of our sin. We return to his covenant. Now he will bless us with the prince. And the prince of peace is sort of like when David was done, he raised up Shlomo. Shlomo was the prince, because Shlomo became the king, and he was a peaceful man. He brought peace to the land. Yahuwah, through Yahushua, the anointed in heaven, is bringing peace to our land. Now we look forward to the peace, the prosperity, the good life. Now we can, and through that good life, we will serve Yahuwah. We will stand on our promise to Yahuwah that we will never forsake him, never leave him. It doesn't matter how much wealth he gives us, like he gave to Job, we will serve him forever, and we will remain humble before him. Blessed be the name of Yahuwah. And we thank him for Yahushua, the light, our heavenly Mashiach. So be it.